Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Last Anniversary, a novel book by Leanne Moriarty. Kudos to Moriarty and her ilk. Bring on more the English-speaking world as a better place for The Last Anniversary. The kind that lure you back to the book even when you know you should be doing something else. The kind who stay in your mind when the book sadly ends. The author describes the characters and setting in a manner where you feel you are in the room and as though the characters are family. This story, like many of hers, has rich characters. You get to know them quickly and become vested in their lives. There are always twists and turns to Moriarty's stories, and on such a human level, no Lee child horrors here. How the lie lead to many life-altering decisions. The story dragged a lot in the middle with lots of unnecessary detail. Dread finishing them and then having to wait for her next release. Definitely recommend this and other books by this author. The story ends like a beautiful present adorned with a poofy bow, promising a special surprise by tying all the loose ends into new beginnings. The story is about an island world and two sisters that create the Monroe baby murders to save them, and it does. Then the baby has babies and they have babies, and the story keeps winding on from one love to another. Another book with twists and secret revelations at every corner. No book by this author is ever disappointing. This book doesn't disappoint. There were quite a few characters, many of whom are quirky, and some people may not like keeping up with that many different personalities and the relational connections. Their whole lives have been premised upon their discovery as young teens of an abandoned baby in a tenant home on their property. You don't think a sad tale of two young sisters finding an abandoned baby would be funny and uplifting, but it was. Set for the most part on Srivelli Gum Island, the Down Under Island provides a singular setting for the tale of sisters Rose and Connie, who rear a child claimed to be the abandoned infant of Alice Jack Monroe Island renters during the Depression. Moriarty crams too many social issues stigmas into the last 100 pages, trying to make the book more of a statement than a fun read. Also, the ending for Sophie seems a bit unearned, as the reader is expected to recall minor details that can't compete with the breadth of the uncommon and layered characters the author develops along the way. Good Vacation on the Beach. Enigma is a real character. Her belief systems are put to the test in several parts of the novel. The characters have an intimacy and a depth to them that is very telling of the hard work and research that the author put into her writing. The story is told mostly from the point of view of Sophie Honeywell, an outsider of the Scribbly Gum clan, and occasionally switches to the point of view of a different character to foreshadow an important revelation. Connie's absence allows these characters to face the past and their demons and to take positive steps towards a better future. The story touches on many themes such as postnatal depression and lesbianism through a cast of quirky and seemingly dysfunctional characters who all impact Sophie's life in one way or another, as her presence there impacts theirs. Moriarty has a keen eye on physical and psychological uniqueness of her cast, and these observations make for a very pleasant listen. The indelible Sophie and her accidental family take you on a wild ride, though the ups and downs of a not-so-simple life. She weaves the story with expert deftness and allows each character to develop with human strengths and flaws that make them endearing. Favorite character: Sophie was believable as a single woman approaching 40 with a great career and trying to figure out if it was enough. Leanne has a definite style based on her keen observations of life, but the approach and technique varies from one book to the next, while the readability and entertainment value remains consistent. Stock your pantry with your favorite food and drink, and make a few recipes ahead of time that freeze well and that you can whip out and heat up quickly. Author has a definite gift of making the reader believe in her thought process, then turns the story in the reader 180 degrees without missing a beat. Leanne Moriarty has a gift for keeping you absorbed in the twists and turns of the lives who inhabit her books. The last page of this book would be worth the read even if it wasn't such a wonderful witty book. Luckily though, the whole book has such great characters and so many interesting side stories that you can't put it down. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.